Hi, Laura Kay, and I'm here with Shira Piven. Shira is the director of a film that's here at River's Edge International Film Festival. It's playing Friday the 4th at Market House Theater at 1 p.m., and it's playing Saturday the 5th here at McNally at 1 p.m. And it's called Fully Loaded. It's a dark comedy. It's about two single moms that are out for a night on the town, and I'm going to have her tell a little bit about it. Shira, tell me a little bit about the film. It's my understanding that this film is heightened reality. Most of these situations actually happened to our actresses. Is that right?
They did. Yeah, I'm not even sure it's heightened. It's sort of trying to be, we're trying to make it as real as possible. I sometimes call it a verite comedy. Sometimes, yeah, one audience member recently said, like, I thought it was going to be a dark comedy, so I kept expecting something really scary to happen. And there's kind of intense music at the top, and there's dark edges to it, but it's not necessarily like a super dark comedy. But the verite element is the central event in the film. These two single moms go out for a night on the town, like a night out in LA. Right. And one of them hooks up with a stranger. And then as the film unfolds, the start of the film, we see them fleeing the bar. And we don't know why, and we don't know what happened, but there was something about a guy. And the rest of the film, as it unfolds, we find out what happened that night, and we find out about their lives and their relationships. But it's based on a real event that happened to the two of them, which is kind of my favorite thing about the film, is that the two actresses who play the leads were out one night just as friends, and they had this thing happen. And so the whole film is really based on the real event, and there's lots of real elements in the film as well.
And it's kind of told in flashback, which I think is interesting, to a lot of the events that were important to them and had happened in their lives.
Yep. So they're driving around, and so there's a lot of driving and talking, which is kind of an unusual element to film, and yet it keeps being interrupted by these sort of more active, interesting flashbacks.
Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about the people in the film. Now, the film stars are well-known stage performers and comedians Lisa Ann Orkin and Paula Killen. But tell us about, and they're brilliant in the film, I must say, but tell us about some of the other people in the film that people might recognize a little bit more. There's some famous people in this film.
Yeah, there's some really funny people who have cool moments. Wendy McClendon Covey, who is just in Bridesmaids. She has a scene with Anna Gasteyer, who was a staple on Saturday Night Live for a long time. She's hilarious.
And so, the title of that scene is actually Lesbian Bed Death.
Lesbian Bed Death.
Very interesting.
And it's sort of a little departure from the main themes of the film. And then there's Dave Koechner, who is also a Saturday Night Live guy, who's also in the film Thank You for Smoking, who is also an anchorman. Mm-hmm. And he's someone who, if you don't know his name, you'll recognize his face.
Immediately.
Yeah. And Dweezil Zappa also plays the love interest. And who else?
Lots of great
David
people.
Yao has a little cameo, who's from the punk band Jesus Lizard.
It's a good ensemble. And then, of course, our two main stars.
Oh, also Jake Labatz, who's another musician.
Yeah, Jake Labatz. He's an accomplished bluesman in addition to playing a good role in the film. Oh, I tell you who else. Mark C. Boone Jr., who's from a little TV show called Sons of Anarchy, is in this film.
Yes.
So, good trivia there. And also a very short part by a little actress who's best known for her role in The Landlord with Will Ferrell. I have to put that in there because that's my favorite piece of trivia from the film. This is your daughter, Pearl.
Yeah, she's still mad because she plays a boy in the film. She plays Paula's son, who in the film is 6 or 7, and she plays him in a flashback as like a little, you know, like 2.5, 3-year-old baby.
Mm-hmm. Very cute. Very cool.
And my mom's in the film. She's here too. She's here in Paducah with me, and she has a really nice moment as Lisa's mom. Mm-hmm.
She does. It's funny. And that's Joyce Piven, who actually has had, I think, a legendary theater workshop. She did that along with your dad, and still does, and for like 30 years in Chicago, the Piven Theater Workshop. Is that correct?
Yes, Piven Theater Workshop in Evanston. It's been around for 40 years now.
Mm-hmm. So we really hope that everybody comes out and sees the film. Again, it's fully loaded. It's got something for everybody in it, and it's a really good film. It's an important film, I think. It's funny. It's got some serious moments that'll really make you think, and it is going to be at Market House 1 p.m. on Friday the 4th, and at 1 p.m. here at Maiden Alley on Saturday the 5th.